Namaste. Today with me is Mr. Thanpan Thomas, ex-MP, union leader, and above all, he is the man for the media people. He is the man who stood for us, who fought for us, and who was with media organization for a couple of years, many years. So, Thanpan Sahab, you are welcome in Lucknow. It's a heartland of very active politics going on. Elections are around the corner. The very basic thing, I start with the basic politics. Now the new politics is only election. Election and only election. There is no social movement, there is no labor movement. You fight election, you defect people, you topple a government, you form a government. Is it what you came in politics for this?
Nothing. I came to politics with an ideological commitment. I was a student when I joined politics. That is, even before graduation as a school student, which attracted me is a socialist ideology. By the immediate matriculation and all that, I was active in the students' movement. And when in the college, I am active as a political man, ideologically committed with socialist ideology. Subscriber of Mankind, reading Lohia's literature, attracted to socialist movement, took membership at the age of 18 in the socialist party. Then Kerala, having the mainstream of socialist movement in the Praja Socialist Party, I had association to associate with the socialist party, Praja Socialist Party thereafter, and thereafter in its turn as a Samyukta Socialist Party. Then its turn finally coming, the dissolution of the socialist parties and merging with the Janata Party, and I became the first member of parliament from Kerala on Janata Party ticket. Then the trade union movement, as a student I started working with the unorganized sector, and that was, you know, that the scavengers, the lowest strata of working class in India. And the scavengers union I organized in the while I am in the college. The tile factory workers organized, textile factory workers organized, construction workers started organized, headload workers started organized, and then my involvement with the trade union went, and I got related with Hinmaskur Sabha, HMS. And HMS, then HMS inside there were some politics, HMP and HNKP and HMP and HMS and all. But I remained with HMS. And I became a national executive member of the HMS as early as 1960s, 67, or at that time itself. And finally, I became its national secretary. In 1981, after that, national president, I involved with HMS. Even now, I am in their secretariat. 10 years I was its national president. So my movement is, public life is like that. And along with that, what had happened is that I gained a lot of experience by traveling all over India as a trade union leader. And by virtue of a trade union positions, I had occasion to move abroad. Involved with the ILO about 20 to 30 years, and with the international conferences and the association with ICFTU, ITUC and all that. So this is my experience like that. Being a socialist, I moved with the Socialist Party, but Socialist Party was dissolved during emergency. And that dissolution took place when I was detained under Samisa. And from the jail, we wrote three persons, detainees, wrote to JP and the people outside that Jansangh, Congress O, Lokdal and Socialist Party merging together. Please keep socialist identity. We three, when read underground literature of Janata Party's manifesto, we found that the word socialism is removed from its bio. This we pointed out. We said, let there be a federal party against Mrs. Gandhi's atrocities,
yes,
their rule, but don't dissolve Socialist Party. We three persons signed the detainees, but that letter was rejected. But I, in my mind, always continued the feeling that socialist party and socialist movement should have a separate entity. And that proved now, because the people who merged as Jansankis made BJP. Only thing the Congress of, because Congress is basically a socialist party.
Yes.
The people who came from there remained. In JP movement, JP is the leader of the socialists. And those who they adorned JP, they also continued as socialists in Janata Party. Then I had occasion, Janata Party MP, there were only 8 MPs, Madhu Dandavale, myself.
Yes, yes.
Only the socialists, two socialists only. Others were Congress, Jaipal Reddy and Gujarat doctor, finance minister,
Patel.
Patel,
H.M. Patel,
Dr. H.M. Patel, old people from, three people from Karnataka, they were Congress of people, no socialists. Socialist identity, myself and Madhu Dandavale, you know.
Yes.
So socialist party has become a nullity, or there is nothing in that. At that time, Samaja Party or something like that was there subsequently. So this is the history. I still and continue to be a socialist.
And to the old school.
School of socialists. And in that, I believe that today I was addressing this meeting of Narendra Dev, birth day celebrations, and I associated with them. They started the human socialism in India. That is the Indian socialism. So I believe in that, and I still continue in that. Even now, the socialist party is shaped with that view.
Yes.
The present socialist party, to which I am the president, believes in that ideology, the original socialist ideology of Dr. Ramanavaroya, JP, Acharya Narendra Dev, Achyut Paduvarthan, and those who gave that thought in 1934.
Another thing, I mean, today what is happening, the politics, the entire thing has changed. Now we have career politicians. Now, if you see in the central cabinet, we have too many bureaucrats, S. Jaishankar Prasad, R.K. Singh, that new railway minister, the Hardeep Singh Puri, all these people are, I will say they are talented, they are good, but the fact remains they are bureaucrats first. The training is not there. So don't you feel that your training of a student movement, of a labor movement, of agitation, this all was the grinding, this all was the process of someone who understands society and someone who understands. So somehow today our ministers are far from reality.
You see, what is your experience? I tell you, these people are ruling. For whom? You said about the bureaucrats. Not only bureaucrats, there is another category which you have to find. That is called crony capitalists are
yes,
there.
Yes.
You see, Adani's representative will be there. And there will be Adwani's representatives will be there. And all other capitalist corporates, their representatives are there who are guiding the government. So that what is there is reality is that crony capitalism. So bureaucrat plus capitalist, those capitalists who in turn help the government to continue their regime are there. This is a combination of crony capitalism and plus bureaucrat. And bureaucrat is a paid employee. He will only think about his promotion. He will think about only his discipline. He will think about only his way of income, his dignity. You have seen them, how they move.
Yes, yes.
How they move, how they behave, how they are the Malik, you have seen their behavior.
Yeah.
Have they got the belief of equality?
No.
I cannot accept it. I cannot accept that process of thinking. That process of not thinking is not based on the society's reality.
But the institution of a students' union, the institution of a proper trade union
movement.
And have gone,
and that how long they can continue? Do you think that this bureaucrat and the corporates, crony corporates, will win over when there is a real election? If there is no manipulation of electronic machines. If there is, the people are given the power to elect, to give their own choice. Do you think that these people will get back? Their manipulation is making them to come to power. How this manipulation? Manipulation is based on the basis of religion, on the basis of beliefs, on the basis of groupism, on the basis of power, on the basis of money. And now what is happening? It is not real democracy. It is now moneycracy. Money based things.
Yeah.
If you have got money, they think that they can purchase power. But that is a wrong story. There will be a reaction. Reaction comes from experience. Experience of a common man in the city or in the village. If it is stomach is empty. He will react when stomach is empty. Now everybody's stomach is empty. Everybody is harassed. Joblessness, that is there. You know what is the human index now assessed about India? About 101 in 116. 101 in 116 nations. Lowest like African countries. One against 99. 1% is gaining because of Modi government. That 1% is 1 crore 30 lakhs. 1 crore 30 lakhs people have become rich. That's correct. But 1 crore 30 people coming rich, the other people, 129 crores are poor. If they are given occasion to react to their real experiences and given free hand to vote, this government will not continue. They let us make therefore a venue for free and fair election.
Great. Now there is another thing happening in times to come, and especially after the post-emergency era, we now see a lot of state parties. They have influence in a particular state and beyond that. And truly speaking, there are still only two parties which can say they have a national character. Congress and BJP, there is no doubt about it. Everyone stood against Congress. There was a time we all stood against Congress. You fought against Congress. But today what you feel, for a larger good of the country, or I am not putting a harsh word, to choose the lesser evil, between Congress and BJP, how you rate?
I put it another way around. Between BJP and Congress, Congress will have to select. But Congress has to change, because the most of the people in Congress are BJP. At least there is an element of BJP people still in Congress. When polarization comes, that polarization will take place even from the Congress. Those people will go to BJP, and that we are expecting. But when the polarization comes, majority will be on this side. So Congress duty is that, in the way in which originally Congress was formed as a socialist party, 1934, Congress Socialist Party was formed where Panditji led it, Acharya Narendra Dev led it, Dr. Lohia was there, Achyut Padwardhan was there, JP was there. That is real Congress. So when Congress coming to power, Gandhiji also expected that Congress will take his socialist ideology as their ideology instead of mixed economy policy. Subsequently, Congress has taken the policy of open market economy, and they have gone up to the extent 1991 when Narasimha Rao became the they went to the neoliberal policies, and they started the crony capitalism. They started supporting the corporates. They gave the way to build this corporate influence in the Indian society. Now that is now eating
dominating.
That dominating. That is dominating. And these people are feeding them. That Congress will have to change. Congress is a major party, we no doubt. Congress has to give the lead for other socialists to come together. And Congress itself should reform as a socialist movement and then make an alternate. And this Kisan agitation and trade union agitations and various struggles going under in the country are a base for it.
Yes.
So let Congress help them. Congress has started helping them. Do you know that Congress at any stage helped the Kisan movement? Now they have started helping Kisan movement. You know that Congress, INDUC or Congress trade union movement, what is it? You know the history. But they have started fighting so that there is a change in Congress. Congress should make that change full.
Change or go back to their roots?
Go back to the root, that is a Congress Socialist Party. Then there will be only two parties. Can they Congress make it? If Congress cannot make it, we will make it.
Okay. Mr. Lok, I have a quick question on that. And before that, I must tell my audience also that there is always, because you have taken the name of Acharya Narendra, we are sitting in the hall making his birth anniversary. There is always a thing that Nehru was the person who somehow engineered that how Acharya Narendra loses that 48 by-election. I must tell you my audience, 47, what was the sequence of event? Acharya Narendra left Congress party on principles. He had no amnesty or nothing with Nehru. It was basically on policies. He left Congress and as a decision, he decided that I must leave my MLA-ship also. He resigned as an MLA, went for a bipoll, where Congress as a party took, there was a candidate from Congress side. So I don't find there is anything wrong because Acharya Narendra was fighting an election. And the Congress candidate was Baba Raghav Das. And Baba Raghav Das was a great Gandhiite. He was a great fellow who born in Karnataka or Maharashtra, a Chitpavan Brahman, came to UP, made this his home, made Devariya his home, and he was fighting Acharya Narendra, no riffraff. He himself, in his own words, was a great man. And people must remember that Acharya Narendra lost by 1,000 votes only. Baba Raghav Das, after a year or two, resigned from the Congress, from this MLA-ship, on the cause of when this Congress government put tax that local thing where the sugar cane you make gold and things like jaggery from that kolu we call
sharkara.
It so that when it was taxed on that principle he resigned. So what I am trying to say is people where I'm and my next question is, you had opponent. The best speech, 1956, when Acharya Narendra died, the best speech given by Nehru is in the Parliament. Where he says he misses him. So, this journey of you treating your opponent as your enemy, and not only he, his family, his sister, his brother, his blah blah, this has started.
You see, Acharya ji, if he had he was alive, if his life was there for more than a sudden death. See, and he was guiding the party. He was the general secretary of the party at that time, Praja Socialist Party in 1956. Then I was a student. If he was there, things would have been different.
Yes.
Very different. Because Lohia ji and JP has gone there at that time to the Bhutan movement. And Lohia ji, of course, he has got his own method of approach and a different style of functioning. And he himself is an institution, you know, that he gives that. So, political organization we could not build. And Ashok Mehta and others, they thought that this Congress has accepted Awadhi socialism. So, in a socialism, which is called Awadhi socialism. And their resolution has come. And some people found that Congress will become a socialist party when they are started against. The history would have been different if Acharya ji was alive. And Acharya ji is the person who really give. There is an Indian socialism that is different from Marxian socialism. That is different from, what had happened in the Soviet Union.
Yes.
If you go into the Soviet Union now, and if you say anything about Communist Party, they will beat you in the street.
They will throw you out.
They will beat you in the street.
Yes.
And the China parties have been, China is a red capitalism, corporatism, crony capitalism, red crony capitalism is happening in China. So that communism is not an alternate for India. India, the alternate is only socialism. I say it is not the alternate, it is the mainstream. Mainstream, why I say, constitution preamble, what is written? India is a socialist country.
Yes.
The secularism, the socialism, the democracy, these three things, who preach here? Which party preach here? So that Congress will have to preach the same ideology, and Congress will have to give thought to that, and Congress historical duty is that, and 1934 history is for that. I am of opinion that Congress should change its approach.
Yes.
And the new leadership should understand the people, opportunists who are with the Congress, who support the neoliberalism. Though they have committed the mistake like Manmohan Singh or Chidambaram or some people who supported this corporatism. Even at that time, Congress has a leftist character. Congress, inside Congress, there are socialist ideologies. They all should come together.
A quick question, a very quick question and the last question because we are running out of time. Do you feel this Kisan agitation is going to be the turning point of Indian politics?
Sure. I feel that not only Kisan agitation has paved the way. And in fact, Mamada's victory is not Mamada's victory. I know it inside what had happened. The Kisan agitators decided to move to West Bengal. Mamada was not expecting this much seats. She had a very hard fight. She had adversaries. Her rule is not that much of the people accepting her rule. It is not a support given for her her performance, but it was the support given to her to oppose BJP.
Correct.
And that was created by the Kisan movement. You know that from Kisan agitation, squads and squads, hundreds of people went to even constituencies of West Bengal, went and met the voters, said, we are agitating, we are Kisans, these are the situations in the country, we are starving, people are starving. You look at these brethren, defeat this BJP. They defeated. Mamada got surprise victory. Same thing is going to happen in UP. They have 8 Mahapanchayats they have called Kisan, and they have started this work. That work will overthrow this Yogi government. One thing. Second thing, along with that, the thing that the workers, 4 laws have come. That laws, the 4 laws of in the Kisan sector has taken away the right of the Kisan. The 4 laws which the codes which have been brought in the labor movement, labor law, has taken away the right of the labor. The Mazdoor, they should also come together. All the trade unions should join together and form one trade union in India. And they should also give a call for indefinite strike along with the Kisans. Suppose there is an indefinite strike called by the workers, railway will stop, airlines will stop, port will stop. Workers are no way interested in this government. Even BJP worker is not interested in this government. BMS is against this government. Now it is time that the workers call for a indefinite strike. So workers and Kisans together just call for an indefinite strike, this government will come down.
Okay. So with this note that you will be returning to UP after some time, maybe
sure,
during the elections.
Sure.
Thank you so much, Mr. Thomas, for joining us. Thank you so much.